Hey, what's up, guys? Tyler here with Secure Team. Now, I wanted to talk about a couple of things today, the first of which is a new piece of Soho footage, basically capturing something that could either be the size of Earth or something that could be closer to the satellite, but no less was captured flying past the sun, going at such a high rate of speed that it only appears in a couple of frames. And I had discovered this footage yesterday, however, I was in the middle of creating my video about all of these rocket launches and such that I posted yesterday, so I didn't have time to talk about it. So here is that clip that you're seeing, and I'm looping it over, and this still image giving us a clear view of something that was captured passing this left quadrant of the sun on January 10th. And as you're watching the video here, which has been verified and is on the HelioViewer website, and I'll post the link to this down below. And what's so great about it that helps us determine this is not just a glitch is that it actually has a circular or egg shape to it, and it has a trail being left behind it, which some have said is indicative that this object was in fact very, very close to the sun, so close that it caused this object to become heated and to interact with the sun, thereby then causing this trail to stream off of the back of it. And again, I don't know. Now, if this was anywhere near close to the sun, that would indeed make this object probably the size of Earth. But obviously, we just don't know. These satellites around our sun, we have one at the back of the sun, one in the front. We have millions of miles of distance in between. But that's not to say that mysterious unknown objects haven't visited our sun in the past, interacted with it. In fact, after you guys finish watching this video, I'm going to post a link. You'll see it on the end card of the video, and I'll also put it down below, where I talk about some of the strangest phenomenon that has ever been recorded happening at our sun. And I think after you watch that, especially if you're new to the channel, it'll give you a better idea of just how special our sun is, and that we here on Earth may not be the only ones utilizing its energy, and that in fact there are much larger, bigger, unknown things out there doing the same thing. So be sure to remember at the end of the video, check that other clip out that we posted a year or so back. Now, in other news, we have a new clip here where one of the top UFO researchers in the field, a woman by the name of Leslie Keen, goes on national news and once again, in my eyes, validates the fact that the UFO phenomenon is the biggest story happening around the world at this moment. So give this a watch. Let me know what you guys think down below. I'm going to get back to working on another video. I'll have that up as soon as I can. So stay tuned, stay safe, and I'll see you all back in just a bit.
But UFOs turn out to be real. We're not kidding. Recently, the New York Times profiled a secret $22 million Pentagon program that investigated unidentified flying objects. Doesn't mean they're from outer space, but they're not identified, and they're flying, and they're objects. The program wasn't bogus. Investigators found multiple aircraft encounters they could not explain. And they've even been storing metal alloy recovered from the vicinity of these encounters. Leslie Keen wrote about this in the New York Times, that piece in question. And she also wrote a book called UFO Generals, Pilots, and Government Officials Go on the Record. She spent years investigating UFOs with the support of former Bill Clinton chief of staff, by the way, John Podesta. Leslie Keen joins us tonight. Leslie, thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me, Tucker.
So that piece, I think, vindicated a lot of work that you've been doing for an awfully long time and certainly got my attention, and I've stopped making fun of people like you and started paying attention. This seems like a huge story. So I know that it's vast and hard to sum up, but if you could just briskly tell us what we think we know about these sightings.
Well, we do know that there are objects in the sky and sometimes in the water that demonstrate extraordinary capabilities that experts say we don't have on this planet. We don't have the capability of creating the kind of technology that, or apparent technology that's been observed by high-level officials for many, many decades. The Pentagon program is the most recent discovery, but these things have been studied in other countries and by our country for many years.
So what percentage of these sightings are we sure are not weather phenomena or experimental aircraft?
Well, that's a really good question, because most sightings of UFOs that just people report are identifiable. I mean, we're talking about a very, maybe 5 to 10% of all the sightings that are called in are not explainable. And what the ones that are really of interest are the ones reported by military pilots, by commercial pilots, by trained observers, multiple witnesses, ones that are caught on radar. Events that have a lot of data to support them and involve very, very credible people.
So I guess what bothers me most about this story is how clearly people who should have been following up and paying attention haven't been. And the case that sticks with me, November 7th, I think, 2006, at Chicago O'Hare Airport, 4:15 in the afternoon, gate C-25, I believe, the pilot of the plane waiting to depart to Charlotte looks up and there is a saucer hovering not that far over the plane. People in the tower see it, other pilots see it, dozens of people see it. It's real, and the FAA refuses to investigate. How could that be?
I know, it's shocking. It's absolutely shocking to me. I mean, they refuse to investigate, I think because they, I mean, who knows what the bigger reason probably is that it's very, they can't explain these things, and they just want, you know, they don't want to deal with them. It might frighten people. They don't have enough information. They don't like to say, well, there's something hovering above an airport, but we don't know what it was. So basically, they will come up with other explanations for it, such as that it was a weather phenomenon. That's what the FAA said about O'Hare, which is really an insult to the pilots who witnessed this thing and many other observers who know that it wasn't weather. I mean, it was a metallic-looking disc-shaped object that hovered over the, as you said, hovered over a terminal, gate C-17 for about 5 minutes, and then it shot straight up through the clouds. This was an incredible aspect of the thing. It was hovering below a cloud bank, and all of a sudden it just shot straight up really fast through the cloud bank and cut a hole in it. So there was like a cookie cutter clean hole in the clouds. You could look up and see the blue on the other side. And you know, as far as anybody knows, as far as I know, and from what I've been told, we don't have machines in the sky that can do things like
but,
that.
But I mean, this is not a potato field in Maine in the 1950s at 3 a.m. This is Chicago
right.
O'Hare, one of the biggest, busiest airports in the world, in the middle of the day, in front of sober witnesses, including pilots and the control tower. And the FAA says, we're not that interested? Like, how could that be?
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's very bad. I appreciate how baffled you are, Tucker, because I'm baffled too. And you can imagine that the witnesses involved with this, you know, it's an insult to them. I mean, there are many witnesses, and we're talking about military people, you know, high-level people in the Air Force, the Navy, the other military commercial pilots who are just told that we're not interested in what they saw. And it's very difficult for a lot of them because they're patriotic people.
Well, yeah, I mean, what if it's the Chinese military? I mean, I believe you because you are, I think, the preeminent researcher on this question. But it beggars belief that the U.S. government would just sort of let it go. Anyway, I appreciate it. Leslie, thank you for coming on. It's an honor to have you.
Thanks a lot, Tucker. I appreciate your interest in it.